What's up, folks, and welcome to an episode of Stars of Tomorrow, an FM20 Wonder Kids series. We look at some young players on their game and we see how they get on the course of their careers. Both players I pick and players that you guys suggest to me as well. Also, down below, guys, if you want to get involved in this series, it's my favourite series to do because it's so interactive, or based on interaction at least. Leave as much info on a player as you possibly can. There's no playoff limits, guys. I will look at any player you suggest. But obviously, we are looking at the big player, the big stars on the game. But if a player don't work out, guys, I'll always try and find... not try and make him look good, but just give you an honest assessment of what I think he's best suited for league and club-wise. So leave as much info on players you can down below. And also, check the playlist as well. Make sure your players haven't been done recently, already been done. Because obviously, that would waste your time. If I don't see the comments... comment for 2 or 3 days and then I replied to 2 days later saying so many has been done already, it would be a bit of a downer for you, wouldn't it? So yeah, so the player we're doing today is, again, I think it's just his player, but it's a goalkeeper. I don't usually do goalkeeper, so I thought we'd do something a bit different today to do a goalkeeper. And Manuel Gasparini, I nailed that, which is really, if I have, I'm very surprised. So in turn, this could be quite a quick review because not really look at goals in the system. If he gets goals assist, guys, keep the best keeper in the world. So, this is very weird to do because I'm not really good at... I've never done this in regards to goalkeepers. Physicality, we don't need to focus on that too much. Mental stats are very young. So, overall, 11 standout stats here. Good reflexes at 14. Good one-on-ones. Eccentricity at 4, which is good. So, he's not a Barthez. He's not now at the moment. And again, he's 17 years old, he's a very young goalkeeper, but good handling, good kicking, good one-on-ones for a goalkeeper at 17 years old. It's not bad, is it? There's potential to grow there. So 17 years old at Udinese, 105k worth. He's been there, how long has he been there for when he gets it loads up? 3 seasons, so you can probably pick him up. Not sure how much you pay for him, because FM's fees are completely bizarre. I mean, Erling Haaland this year is so cheap, it's ridiculous. Maybe a new patch might start a new game at some point when I get around to do it. So yeah, let's go forward, guys. It might be quite a short review because not much to really talk about in terms of the stats on the career stats, but we'll see how we get on. First jump, here we go. Well, folks, he's moved to Man City he's now 20. Oh, so I was about to say 20 million quid then. He's 20 years old. See what happened there? I think obviously the big attribute of this guy is his reflexes and positioning's 15 as well. So that is interesting. So quite a, you know, I'm trying to describe him as a good reflexes. De Gea, you know, just like quickly reacting to something. You know, he's got a bit of that in him. Rest of the stats pretty much the same. 1.8 million pound injury record, pretty injury free. Again, he's a goalkeeper, so that's not going to be an issue massively as before. So how much did they pay for it? They paid 4.7 million. Not a good goal against this guy. There's no point. 4.5 million pound minimum cost, 9.25 maximum cost. He's got potential. But this is a key point now. Again, they've got to play him, or at least loan him out somewhere to get him football. Not bad for the money, about right for fees. And I think definitely scope to improve quite well. The key thing now, guys, is to play him. Definitely play him. Let's see what City do with him. So, folks, he's still at Man City, and he's got a 16 aerial reach, 1-on-1 17, reflex of 16, kicking 15 as well, good positioning at 16, and jumping reach of 16 as well. So, decent keeper, not quite at the elite level that you'd like him to be at. Let's look at the injury record, and again, pretty okay overall. We'll be injured for a broken toe in training. So, let's see if we've been playing him. Not much that season. Nope. Got more games that year in the league. 8 games in the league. And then, again, so he's not been played much. So we look at the stats here. He's not getting played much, and he's still developing quite well. If you were to play him a bit more, I think you'd get more out of him. I'm not saying you'd start him by any means, but if you were to develop him and loan him out more and get him some football in the lower leagues, the one-on-ones are there, reflexes are there, and the air reach is there as well. You can just improve these two bits here, and that, you've got a good goalkeeper here. Throwing, I'm not too bothered by that, because if you're playing a short passing game, it's not massive, that issue, though that could be a bit better, of course. But again, I think just like a game time is an issue, and I think it's an issue last year as well with some of these players. They just didn't play him enough. Big clubs bought them thinking they're going to be good and then decided not to play them. Kind of like Chelsea used to do, like buy a lot of players massively on youth, loan them all out. But in this case, they don't do that on here. They don't do the second bit Chelsea did. So yeah, let's go forward again, guys, and see how he gets on. So folks, he is now at Arsenal. He's 30 years old, worth £19.5 million, and it's basically staying the same. So I'm... Because his keepers are new for me, I'm going to stop it at this point. I think the overall opinion on this guy is you've got to loan him out. See, he's barely played him. He's been playing a bit more at Arsenal for £1.4 million. I think it's just, if you get him, loan him out to a decent, if a lower league club in England or wherever you are. Loan him out, gain some experience, because it's there, isn't it? Kicking's not bad. Pass handling's good. Reflexes are good. One-on-ones are good as well. Good aerial reach. Good jumping reach. Just needs that bit more first-team experience early in his career, and you've got a good keeper. And the fees is not bad. 8.25 rise is 9.25 City paid for him. So I think get him in your team, get him in the youth team, but the second you can loan him out, get him out on loan somewhere, because there's a keeper in there, and you've seen here, even with limited football, he looks half decent, right? So get him out on loan, get him some football, and I think you've got a good keeper here. Thank you so much for the suggestion, my friend. Keepers are a bit weird for me. I don't usually do keepers because it's kind of limited what you can really talk about outside of the main screen here at the start. So I'll open to those again. If you've got more goalkeepers, guys, feel free to post the goalkeepers and defenders as well. I'm okay to do those. Obviously, a lot of people go for more attacking players, but I'm open to do defenders as well. But obviously, guys, like I said before, down below, leave a like and a comment on the video. Comment about a player you want to see me do, or comment about this player. I will say, guys, if you make like a lot of suggestions, I can't guarantee I'll do every single player that you suggest straight away. I'll make sure I do a couple of them at least. So if you make like 8 suggestions, I'll do at least 2 or 3 of them. But to be fair to the people as well, I want to get their players on the series as well. So I can't just go through every single player. You make a list of 20 players and go through them all. But I will make a note of, okay, that player, I want to look at him. And because I do a little bit of a heads up on and see what, you know, I'm looking at as a base stats, follow the game up and look at them so I get an idea of what we're looking at. So I will make a note of your players and make sure I get to them. But I want to make sure everyone gets their player on as quick as possible. This is a bi-daily series at the moment because of the time it takes to record them and render things out. But simulate. So yeah, thank you for watching, folks. I will see you in the next episode. But until then, thank you so much for watching. Bye-bye.